This is an after-action report for Flashpoint Campaigns Red Storm. The scenario is Test of Wills, and it's being played by email, traditional email. We'll take a look at the scenario description and our orders. I'm commanding the NATO forces to defend these positions. The victory point locations are 1700, 1500, and a couple of thousand in the north. The victory condition is for me to have approximately 60%, maybe two-thirds is probably about right. So I'll need to hold on. There are 8,400, of which I have already 2,800 victory points. So that's just over 11,000. I'll need about 60% of that, or two-thirds. So that makes just about maybe 8,000. I'll try to hold. My plan will be to occupy and try to hold these four or five positions in the south. This should give me approximately, that's 3, that's 4, 5, 6, 75, 80, 200 points, and enough to get at least a marginal victory. I'm not sure if I have enough forces. The area is just so large, I'm just not certain if I have sufficient forces to hold them all. I'm going to grab all the victory points I can, just in case the enemy doesn't have a chance, isn't able to take them away from me. At least I'll hold them that way. I have a number of forces, TF herd, some mechanized infantry, and a few tanks. What I've done is the visibility at this point is just terrible. So we'll use the Control L function to see. This is about as far as I can see, even with the superior optics of the Bradley, which has a thermal imaging system. They don't see very far. No more than maybe 500 meters. So that's right, I'm putting them right up on the line, point blank range. At point blank range, we can see what the enemy has. All his reconnaissance units, his main battle tanks, but mostly his armored personnel carriers. We can see that they have quite deadly at short range. And my units and his mechanized infantry has short range rockets, grenade launchers, rifles, grenades. So he can kill me, and I can't even use my longer range weapons. We'll see. The longer range weapon, this is the range of my weaponry. So I can fire a lot further than I can actually see, but I can't see it. So my Bradleys are unable to use their missiles to best advantage by engaging the enemy at long range. Instead, I won't be able to see them until they're right on top of me on the barrier. And there's not much choice. As long as the weather stays bad, I don't have it. I don't think I can defend further back and give them a free access to the barrier. So I've got to challenge them on the line and fight it out and just lose tanks and men. To this end, I have a number of engineer battalions. Companies. I have 3 engineer companies, and currently in this game, there are no advantages to having engineers. They should be my crown jewels and be able to lay mines and fortifications and barriers. I should be trying to protect them as best I can whenever possible. However, because they have no special abilities, I may as well just use them up as infantry. And I'm putting them all up on the line. It's a long line to defend. So my strategy will be try to make the enemy pay and then try to funnel him, let him chase the points in the north, may give them free or easier points, but make him pay heavily for anything that he comes through the center along this line. In the south, I have a lone cavalry scout unit, and he's got pretty decent sensors to watch the area. His role is to die gloriously and report any enemy activity in the south. He'll get no help. If he sees none, he's just here as to prevent the enemy from have a free shot at the minefields or trying to cross the minefields. If he takes a few with them, that'd be just fine. But I don't expect him to survive very long if the enemy comes. But his role is just to say, here they come, or across the south. I've deployed one mechanized infantry battalion across the south to cover this opening. They've got some pretty decent fields of fire. But even though they can't see anything, so they may not fire. If the weather doesn't lift, these guys will be wasted trying to cover it. They should be able to just hammer him as he comes through this entrance, but if the weather does not change, they are wasted. I've got my artillery park hiding. I have a multiple rocket launcher system, or multiple launch rocket system, as well as two howitzer companies. My first order of battle, I'm going to use one to lay mines. I approach every scenario as though it's a blank slate, so I pretend I know nothing, even though I've played this scenario from both sides in both multiplayer and solitaire. You got to play it this way so not take advantage of knowing what the enemy has or where he might be deployed or where he could be coming from. So try to make decisions. I personally try to make decisions based on what I see in the map and the situation according to where the victory points are located. So I ordered the other... Since they have no targets, I've ordered the artillery to try to load up as much as they can into resupply mode. But I'm using one artillery red company. I'm going to be deploying the mines. We have scattering mines. I'm going to try to... There's a number of bridges across the river, but only one's intact. So I'm going to try to bottle them up, if possible, by throwing a minefield at the exit of the bridge. And I have three possible fire missions. I'm going to try, if I don't run out of mines, I'll try to lay a mine on the other side of the river. Every minefield will cost him approximately 30 minutes to clear when he runs into them. And if he runs into them, I can then bring more artillery fire onto it from after seeing any explosions. But if I am lucky and can lay one here and here, hopefully as he tries to cross, I can delay him here and again here. My third minefield will be just at the entrance to this. I rarely get three mine missions out of a fire unit, so this is a bonus mission. It's almost a throwaway, but I may as well try to fire it because I'm not being paid to take home ammo. So if I use them all up, that's fine. I've got a couple of tanks platoons here to help cover. Once they move into this position, they'll hopefully be able to bring fire onto this area. Still, their lousy sensors just... I just can't believe how poor this is. Now we're all fighting on almost equal terms with the Soviets because I can't see them to use my longer range guns and missiles. And they can, once they get close, there are more of them. See, my units here are only 10 squads or 8 squads or 4 squads. But the enemy motorized infantry companies have 23. So they outnumber my units 2.3 to 1 in number of squads. And that means they fire more often, and every time they fire, they can kill something. I've left an infantry, a cavalry scout in front. Hopefully, with his superior sensors, he can give an idea of, he can see it coming, and maybe these units will be able to fire. I don't know. I'm not sure if a cavalry unit can spot for missile fire from the Bradleys, but I don't think so. I'm just hoping so. I put other engineers on the line. They're to act as speed bumps should the enemy be coming through here. They're just to die gloriously. Backing them up are some regular mechanized infantry, but I've pretty much put all the engineers on the line and interspersed them with a few mechanized infantry companies. Not even that big. Platoons to strengthen them. In the northern part of the line, I've got another regular mechanized platoon at the headquarters, and I even committed the air defense. Now the air defense, I don't know if the enemy, because we have to play this as though we assume that the enemy has air support, that he would either have bombers or fighters or helicopters. So I've got the Vulcan air defense. It does have a capability against air to ground, I hope. Yeah, area defense. So I've got him anchoring the far end of the line. If the enemy should decide to try to build a bridge and approach here, that'll cost him 30 minutes to try, and he'll be totally exposed on the river. So I'm hoping I can, if he decides to come this way, I'll at least be able to see him, and the air defense, the Vulcans are very thin-skinned and they die easily. Maybe he'll get a shot off at least. If he comes up the road this in this direction, I'm hoping the rest, the mechanized platoon and the air defense will be able to fire upon him. We can see that they do fire. They do have the range to fire, but they don't have the visibility. So everything's going to be at point-blank range. I have an anti-tank platoon up high. Great view. Can cover the road if you can't see it. So I'm gambling a lot on hoping the weather will improve. Now we're playing with limited orders on, so we can see that limited staff orders. So I have to really protect my headquarters company. Normally I would put them into the line and just, if there were unlimited orders, I put them in the line because they have some valuable Bradleys that can actually fire something that's worthwhile. But because I have a limited number of orders, I have to protect the headquarters units. If I don't, I only have, I think, 12 or 15 orders I can issue per turn. Once I start losing headquarters units, then I lose the ability to control the battle, and I lose the ability to issue orders. And I've seen some battles where a side is only able to issue two orders because a number of the headquarters are knocked out. So I've got to hold them back, keep them out of the line of fire in order to maintain chains of command and lines of communication. I've got a couple of tanks up here. I'm hoping to have a trap here so he can fire right down the line. As well, this tank will be able to fire cover up to here and down this line should the enemy try to come down here and turn in towards one of these. So I'm hoping to catch him in the flank, surprise him with that. I've got a couple of mechanized platoons defending this point, as well as my another anti-tank launcher. So I've got fairly decent fire if I can actually find him. These victory point locations have not been claimed yet, so I've got to get a unit over to them. I'm going to be using my air defense units, my Chaparral SAMs, simply because they don't have any anti-surface ability, so they can't fire on the tanks or infantry, so I'm using them to collect points and then holding a position in the rear to warn. I also have another headquarters unit up in the north, and he's armed very lightly, so I'll have him running across and then also holding a position here to warn me if and when the enemy comes through the north. He's acting as an artillery spotter, the same as these SAM units. That's pretty much all they can do in this dark time with visibility so low. So I've got them spread out. I've got another SAM unit here running across to pick up the victory points and then find a final holding position here. He's to give some warning, hopefully, for the artillery park should the enemy decide to go down this road, but I don't see why he would, because the victory point locations are here and here. It wouldn't be any need for him to run down this area. That's my plan. I'm sure that the professionals will be laughing at my reasoning, but it's the best I could come up with. My opponent is very good at finding the highest point and covering locations for his units. I'm just not so good. I'm pretty much guessing with my best guess. The first enemy units appear right where I thought they might be, down the gap. The minefield is deployed successfully. Coming up the northern road, the enemy engages one of my engineers and kills a squad. Obviously, his visibility is not impaired from a distance. He's shooting me at 1,500 meters, even though the visual is only should be 500. So I'm in an odd situation where the enemy can actually see me and I can't see him. I always thought the NATO sensors were superior. My mistake. The cavalry opens fire with their long-range missiles. The engineers keep taking it on the chin. The cavalry doesn't seem to be getting much effect on this grouping, and other enemy units appear. The visibility has improved to 2,000 meters, so at least we're getting some shots off. The cavalry engages at 2,000 meters. Excellent. But if I can see him, he can probably see me. This is killing range. 1,000 meters difference. Two hexes. Three tanks have exploded. So we're getting the first shots in. But we're also paying a price. The anti-tank tow launcher hits one in the field. Even behind, within a forest and behind the barriers, the mechanized platoon is taking a hammering, as is the other mechanized platoon. Our Bradleys are making excellent targets for the enemy today. Just being brutalized. Notice how large the units are. This is a 12 tank unit and 27 squad unit here. So that takes a lot of killing. And he's just butchering my mechanized platoon. We take out one of his anti-tank units, but these are really cheap. But they can still kill Bradleys and tanks. He doesn't seem to be moving. I guess he seems to be looking or conducting reconnaissance, so he hasn't moved off the line of departure and hit any of these obstacles. Perhaps that's a prudent move. He's sitting still and just shooting, but he's pretty effective in his shooting. More explosions in the gap. I've noticed that the enemy had a shorter decision cycle than me, so he had his initial orders, and then after 27 minutes he was able to issue a second set of orders. 1 minute later, that's when the cycle has returned to me. And those, his decision cycle seems to be shorter than mine, so he's inside my decision loop. I don't have very many things to do, other than I only have 17 orders, but I pretty much have the units where I want to set them up. This platoon's been brutalized, but there's not much I can do to pull it out. Now that it's all the Bradleys have been destroyed, I think it's probably hidden from the enemy. He can't see it because it's just a couple of infantry squads left over hiding in the woods. I've ordered the rest, most of my units already are finishing up their resupply. Even though their resupply levels were very high before, 95-94%, I want every last bullet possible before the enemy starts charging through the gap. We're going to have to hit them with every single weapon we have on our hands. The cavalry unit in the south has detected nothing, so I'll order her to conduct resupply, and if he sees nothing for another hour or so, I'm going to try to pull him back and provide some support in the center. Artillery wise, these are my big guns, and I've got my heavy howitzers. I've targeted them against this T-80 tank. Now, if he hasn't been, since he didn't move at the beginning, and unless he's got some delay on here, he hasn't moved now, he probably got an order to move at the 27-minute mark, so he won't be able to move for another 30 minutes, 25, 30 minutes or so, so he should be sitting still for me to hit him. Because he's under observation from probably this unit, we'll hit Control U to see, no, this unit doesn't see him, this unit doesn't see him, this unit doesn't see him. This will show which units are able to actually spot. There it is. The engineers have him under observation. And because we don't have the little white dot here, the engineers have not been counter-detected. Good. So Control U is kind of an interesting, Control Y is kind of an interesting feature. So because we have him under observation, my guns, I'm hoping, are going to be more effective. They generally are more effective, in my experience. I don't know if it's a deliberate in the game, but it does seem that way. So under observation, these guns, I hope, will take a terrible toll on him. My other battery of howitzers, 155mm howitzers, are going to aim for this tank unit. It only shows six, but maybe I'm not sure if we destroyed some of them. We'll take a look. We'll hit the Control U to hide the units. Actually, we'll hit Control U to hide the units. And we see there's been a couple of explosions here, so we probably knocked out three tanks already, three or four tanks. But with six tanks, it's worth three artillery, three barrage. Why am I putting so much artillery on him? Well, he's in motion already, as is this one. With the little red dot, we see he's already been given orders. So I'm hoping that with the 2.05 version of this game, which we're playing, that by having him under observation, they will be able to redirect the artillery should he move out of that hex. I'm gambling. These are in motorized rifle companies. Look at how big they are. 28 units, 28 squads. That's a lot of killing that needs to be done. Each one must be killed, and most of them are able. There's 9 troop armored personnel carriers, 5 mechanized rifle squads, 3 grenade launchers, and 1 SA-14 Gremlin surface-to-air missile, and 3 headquarters units. All of these can kill any of these. So I've elected, I'm going to use my big gun, my mobile launch rocket system, or multiple launch rocket system, and it will hit this hex along with the one hex surrounding. So I'm hitting this hex, I'm going to hit this hex, and this hex, and this hex at the same time, as well as this hex. I can't see anything here, but I suspect if these three are filled, there's probably another unit in this hex too. So I'm losing the effect on two of my, these are going to be hitting empty hexes, but the launch rocket system should be able to massacre most of these infantry units. So I've elected to use them in this manner and not against the north. I can only fire them against one target, unfortunately. My mortars are going to try and take out one of the we won't be able to kill all 27, but I'm hoping that I can inflict some serious casualties on it with infantry moving in the open. Oh, not open, its coverage is 70%. So he's kind of hidden, but I'm hoping that because it's spotted fire, it should be effective enough to take him apart. In the north, we haven't seen very much happening. No explosions in the minefield, so I'm not even sure if he's coming in this direction. That's what the situation is at 2228. Let's see what happens. We exchange fire with the anti-tank platoon, and we catch some of them in the open with the Bradley and their missiles. The chain gun gets another. He's already massacred the Bradleys of this unit, and they continue to be punished by it close range. My first anti-tank launcher is destroyed from a missile. See, they're very thin-skinned, my air defense and my anti-tank units. If you can see them, they can die easily. We're catching him on the road, but we're not hitting them hard enough. He's hitting me just as hard, returning fire. So maybe that was a good ploy of his we're fully resupplied. Maybe that was a good ploy to sit the first turn and just spot targets, because we're shooting it out and I'm on the losing end. My anti-tank unit is worth much more than his measly anti-personnel carriers, even if it kills the infantry unit within, and we're not doing it. Because he's deployed, we have to kill each unit at one at a time, so we need 27 hits in order to kill this entire unit when it's deployed. It says wheeled right now, so he might be loaded up, ready to move. So by killing the carrier, we might get the subunit at the same time, but that's not a certainty. Artillery fire is registered on my engineer and the hard-hit mechanized platoon. Another engineer squad dies. Some heavy guns are registered on the anti-tank platoon. He's got all the targets registered, and they're all suffering. He's got some pretty heavy artillery, or at least lots of it. There goes my grenade launcher. Here comes the smoke. He's trying to cover his advance. Well done. At a range of 2,000, I probably won't be able to see through the smoke screen. But he doesn't realize I've got a unit on the other side that can spot for me. He's just hitting the... In general, he's just hitting the victory points, assuming that I might have a unit on there. That's a good point. That's a good little strategy if he has extras. But I've also learned the thing, and I'm staying off the bullseyes. I consider these bullseyes, and I'm staying the hell away from them. Notice that this was the location of my SAM unit. Now he's picking up the SAM radar, and he's tracking in and trying to kill them. So I'm going to try to keep my SAM units on the move as moving targets, trying to attract the artillery. Here comes the multiple rocket launch system. And the ensuing, but we're killing only one at a time. So obviously his units are deployed. We only managed to kill one infantry squad here. That's terrible shooting. But we see the explosion. We did have a unit back here that we weren't aware. Five explosions, but each, they're all deployed, so we have to blow them up one at a time. The unit, the subunit, the mechanized infantry, and the grenade launchers, and the SAM units are separate from the carriers, so it takes twice as many to kill. We have to kill 22, 21, and 12. That's lots of killing. Not as effective as I'd hope. I'd hope to reduce these by 10 each. The first artillery lands on his lead tanks. I've got my fingers crossed that they'll do better. Nothing. What a waste. And because they missed, the engineers suffer for it. The first cavalry scout dies. The Bradleys are taking an awful beating. We caught him in the open, but these are cheap HQ squads worth 4 or 5 points. Well, he's killing 45, 50 point Bradleys. Not a fair exchange. Not a good exchange. He's been tracking in on, looks like, the presence of the radar from my SAM unit. So long as he's wasting artillery on the SAMs, he's not hitting my frontline units. He must have guessed right and picked up. This is with the position of where the SAM unit started. So he's hitting where it began the game. If he's firing smoke, he's not firing high explosives. Thank goodness. These units had enough. He's doing the headless chicken dance, what I call it. Now that he's been knocked down to a certain level, he's running away and he's going to be shot in the back and just blasted because he's doing it at hasty speed. It's very exposed posture, and I don't expect him to survive the move. My mechanized platoons are brutalized, but at least they didn't get the Bradley with their long-range missiles and gun. The anti-tank unit is also doing its headless chicken dance and is running, as is the cavalry unit. My opponent has chosen his artillery targets quite well. By sitting back, he's spotting for the artillery and he's letting the artillery clear the way rather than going head-to-head at a range of one. I think that's an excellent tactical move on his part. Second barrage goes in. I don't expect to have much more happen with this. Yeah, nothing. What a waste. He's probably in a hold command here, so it's going to be a covered position or covered posture, dug in posture, and that's the best you can have, the most protective. There he was, Bradley. We exchanged a 4-point infantry squad for a 45-point, 50-point Bradley. Not a fair exchange at all. You could pretty much wipe out an entire company of mechanized infantry and wouldn't equate to much more than one M1 Abrams. That's how valuable the Abrams are, and that's how worthless the general infantry are. Look at all those artillery strikes. He must have 18 platoons or companies of artillery just blasting. His guns have no problem hitting me, whereas my 155mm can't even put a dent in his tanks. At least I know if he's laying smoke, this is the direction to which he's hoping to advance. And the electronic sensors on my M1 Abrams, this is a headquarters unit, unfortunately, it only has two Abrams and a personnel carrier. But at least I should be able to engage him from up to about this distance if he can get past the barriers. When he gets past the barriers, not if. Unfortunately, I have ordered my SAMs. They've stopped moving. So now he's going to be collecting barrage after barrage after barrage. They're going to die because it takes 30 minutes for them to get moving again. And that delay for the orders to transmit down to him is going to cost me. The mortars get into it. And we start dropping on the mechanized platoon or mechanized company. The mortars can do probably a little bit more effective against the infantry and the lightly skinned armored personnel carriers than they would against the tanks. My third barrage goes in. I expect nothing from it as usual. We'll be lucky if we get a single tank out of all three of them. What a waste. Could have been killing infantry, mechanized rifle companies. So that's six strikes against tanks, not a single hit. My artillery and rocket launcher system displace. Now the battlefield has returned to 500 meters. We've lost track of everything, and we're blind, and the enemy can see us, but we can't seem to see him. We've killed off the entire company, looks like, at the entrance. He hasn't even hit the minefields yet. Our first tank from a mobile from the rockets, the tow from the Bradley. His first smoke screen is already dissipated, and he hasn't even started moving towards it yet. The next 2 minutes pass without much damage from either side. With not many targets, I've decided to put the artillery onto these few. I'm going to hammer the infantry company as well. There's a headquarters company here that's going to get a fair share of mortars. Now, because we're in limited orders phase, if I can knock out a few of these headquarters companies, maybe I can reduce the number of orders the enemy gives. And that would also reduce the number of artillery missions he can assign. My SAMs are taking it because it's trying to rearm, and he's detecting the radar. And in this game, there's just no way to turn off the radar. So your radar, even if you're out of ammo and you're resupplying, they leave it on anyway. And that just draws in all the artillery. I've tried to rearm some of my other ones. In the northern flank, I've got two on either side of the mech platoon. The mech platoon is trying to hold the ground while the other two are rearming to maximum readiness. They didn't use a lot, but I'm not sure if the enemy is coming through the north, but I'd rather be ready than sorry. Enemy is dropping artillery all over. I'll make a note of my main headquarters. I have to keep it moving all the time. If the moment she stopped, she's gonna die, because the radio direction finding is pretty good, and the moment she stops, before she can get started again, she'll have a 30-minute delay, and that 30-minute delay, she'll be annihilated. At least that's what I would do if I detected the enemy. Our first artillery mission goes in against the mechanized rifle company. The enemy drops more smoke, and he's pretty much telegraphing his route of advance. Why waste all this smoke if he wasn't planning to come through here? The visibility is still terrible at 500 meters, but we're keeping an eye on the line, and it doesn't seem as though he has tried to, or he's moved on to any of the wire barricades or minefields. He's being patient, which is good. He's being methodical. He's trying to erase he's using his artillery to its maximum benefit by trying to erase some of my units, which is very aggressive, and you can't fight back against it. Makes me wonder what he's trying to hit over here, because there hasn't been a unit here for quite some time, but he must be getting some kind of intel, thinking that that's where I am. Yes, the SAM unit that had gone by quite a long time ago all the way through here and is now refueling, rearming here. Went through here, here, and is now here. So he's aiming at old locations, which is fine with me. The more he blasts on empty fields, the less he blasts my real units. I'm going to count my lucky stars. He hasn't hit. He's only hit one unit, and he hasn't caused any damage to it. Here go my mortars against the headquarters unit. No effect. The heavy 155mm howitzers are punishing it, but not very well. It's still got at least 10 units here. They should be killing it much more easily, but it must be well deployed and spread out in a hold order. Hold order is dug in, so it makes it very, very hard to kill. I'm glad the weather plays both ways. If I can't see him, he can't see me either. He's finally tracked in on my self-propelled anti-tank unit, which has already taken losses. He's trying to recover some. Readiness and fuel, so I thought it was in kind of a quiet place. Sometimes I wonder what he's aiming for. This could have been the old, when the headquarters unit came through here, went up through there and was coming back down here again. Perhaps he's aiming at a previous intelligence report. He is three. I've seen him. He's at 3413. It's going to get a major visitation by artillery. My multiple launch rocket system should be ready. 3413. Unfortunately, in the game, there's no way to mark that, so we'll just have to memorize it and attack it later. By his three smoke rings, looks like he's planning to come up this road, and he wants anything here to be blinded. By forcing my cavalry unit to retreat after taking losses, I'm pretty much blind in this area, which is good for him, bad for me. I think he put in his smoke too early, as it's already dissipating. There it comes, incoming fire. The engineers are the first line. It looks like this is a reconnaissance unit. But the engineers aren't very heavily armed either. With a little luck, we can shoot him off the barricades and destroy him before he can clear it. And we're successful. My opponent seems to be dropping smoke like it's going out of style. And an engineer gets hit again. Now I'm wondering why he's putting smoke all the way out here, as if he can even make it in there before it dissipates. Surely he must know this. Well, the more smoke he fires, the less high explosive there is. That's the only way I can think of it. A second company of tanks has appeared. So now we have two survivors plus about 15 underneath. So I assigned my fire missions. Remember from last scene, we had detected a headquarters had been reported at 3413. Well, if the headquarters is shifting automatically, it would have probably moved one hex in some direction, either south or southeast. So he's probably not there anymore. If he is, I've decided to use saturation fire. So I'm going to hit this center hex as well as every hex around here with multiple launch rocket system. If he's moved south or if he moves, I'm going to catch him. And if I get lucky, there's usually things like other headquarters or artillery and valuable sub targets around the major headquarters. So I'm open to blast the entire 7 hex area. Right now I'm going, I still have improved conventional munitions, and I'm going to be dropping all of them on this tank company, hoping to wipe it out. My second 155 millimeter battery is going to drop 3 on these 15 tanks, hoping to wipe them out. I'm spending a lot of ordnance. He's not doing me the courtesy of stacking all his units onto one hex so I can blast them. Confound that good tactics. So I'm going to try to do my best to take them whole group out. This one's stuck on top of a mine right now, on top of a barrier right now, so he's not moving. I'm pretty sure I'm going to get all 3 strikes on him before he can move. This one is a little bit different. He could be moving, I could be wasting it. If he moves right away, and I don't know if he moves into the next hex, the ICM may not track onto it. I'm hoping it doesn't get wasted. My mortar battery is going to try to take out this self-propelled anti-tank unit. Now, the reason why I'm going after a self, not one of the more valuable armored personnel carriers or infantry or tanks or even the headquarters unit, is this is more realistic target of actually killing. The self-propelled anti-tank units are these really cheap four-wheeled. They're only 7 victory points, but they easily have the ability to kill a Bradley, and a Bradley's are worth 42. So he can, that's like a 600% return on investment. I could wipe him out, and if he gets one single Bradley, he's ahead of the game. So that's why I'm aiming him. He's usually a soft, thin-skinned target, so that artillery might actually take it out before it gets in range. One good thing to note is, even though the visual is at 500 meters, if we select one of our Bradleys and hit the Control L to see what it sees, this is now the visual. So obviously the thermal imaging system is now coming into play. We are now seeing long range. Now we've hit Control F, we can see these are the hexes in which we can actually engage. And there's a high percentage, if he comes through here, we will have him with a number of different units can actually fire on him. The rocket launchers, this should be an absolute killing zone if we can get him to come in through this area. Same in the north. We have another killing zone. If he decides to come down this route, we're going to make him pay really, I hope, quite badly. So we've got 2 or 3 units ready to fire their TOW missiles. Even the main gun can cover up a little bit. So in the north, our 2 subordinate units are almost completely ready. They'll be finished resupply in 4 minutes, so I've ordered the covering mech platoon to do the same. Now, as it provided support or cover while the other two were rearming or resupplying, now they'll have to do the same for him. I've also got my SAM units. I'm trying to get them moving. I don't know how well they are before they get hit by artillery. Now, this is going to be kind of weird. Someone might say, why am I running back and forth so far? These are my red rabbits. You can check by their fire. This is the range of the missile, so they get pretty good coverage regardless of where they are. But I'm running them back and forth from distant targets because I never want them to actually arrive at the waypoint. If they actually arrive at the waypoint, that means that one of my waypoints gets used up. and take it off the board. So I always choose something really quite deep in the forest, so that they can't, they, if they start going through there, they'll never get to it, and then I'll switch around and I'll switch the waypoints up to the other side, so they're always running back between waypoints but never actually reaching a waypoint. This, in this manner, I keep all the waypoints active all the time. This is one way to avoid the 30-minute penalty. Once they stop, they're going to die, and they'll attract all kinds of artillery attention. I'm using them, I'm keeping them moving, so that if the artillery comes after them, they're going to have to waste a whole heck of a lot to actually catch them. It isn't impossible. Once they detect it and drop a little bit in front of it, they should be able to kill it because it's on the move, and it's a thin-skinned unit. However, I'm going to make the enemy work at it. Same reason I'm working for the keeping my main headquarters moving. I choose a endpoint deep in the woods, so it's unlikely to ever, if our next turn is 20 minutes or next cycle is 24 minutes, he's unlikely to be able to go all the way into the woods. He'll probably end up here, and then I'll turn him around and run him back and forth along this line just to keep him moving. Once he slows down, once his readiness is gone and he stops, he's going to get creamed by artillery. And we've seen how powerful and how much the artillery the enemy has. So it's just a matter of time until he dies. But I'm going to make the enemy work for it. I'm going to make the enemy earn it. And I've got my other SAM unit doing the same, running back and forth between to a destination they should never reach. Here we go. The enemy's giving me time to set up. I wish he might wish he hadn't given me that extra time, but he's using it well to kill off my covering engineers. Now he's coming down this path, and he's moved away from it, so I'm going to be losing all those wonderful improved conventional munition shots. He's disappeared. He's in here now. That's just smoke. That's fine. We have electronic sensors. That engineer unit's probably going to get wiped out. My return fire lands over where I estimate his headquarters to be. No result. What terrible shooting. There goes the first improved conventional munitions wasted. Let's see the second one. My hope is that they will actually reach the second one and then stack up here and then be killed by one of the subsequent rounds of ICM, if I'm lucky. But I'm not that lucky tonight. My opponent is doing well. He's keeping his units spread out. He's forcing me to waste valuable ICM on individual units. There's the headquarters, still at 3413, but we've just dropped it and had no effect. Here comes that anti-tank unit. There's five of them, so well worth killing. Here comes that tank unit. Up here, unfortunately, he didn't stack up. My opponent is just too crafty. The first enemy unit to run into a minefield, opposite two engineer defending units. The first ICM barrage only managed to kill one tank. Killing them one at a time is just too slow. I was hoping for much better performance from the ICM rounds. The engineers are in the spirit and claim a tank. But lose one of their own in the process. Two tanks are killed by the Bradley. Must be the TOW missile. But the engineers do not have missiles. They simply have the gun atop the M113. What an expensive waste of valuable munitions. I should have waited until they hit the barrier, and now I've run out. So that's my fault. Finally, the ICM takes its toll. Five tanks destroyed in one salvo. That's about right. And the mortar's quite useless. We seem to be wiping out the self-propelled artillery unit, but all he has to do is he just needs to get one, and he evens the entire score. Notice how well he spread out on all of them? He's only had a few units on each, so he's not concentrating it. He's very careful of it. That's good for him, but bad for me. My future plan, I think I'll try to drop a minefield somewhere here to stop him up. Once I hold him here, then I can hammer him with this tank unit. Looks like we wiped out the self-propelled anti-tank unit. Good thing. My engineers are about to get overrun. The enemy has fired his smoke too far ahead. And the engineers continue to fight on doggedly, taking another tank with them. Unfortunately, my mech platoons are running low on ammunition. They're going to have to rearm soon. That fire came from this hex, so he's obviously got units here waiting to go north. The Bradley's one tank unit totally destroyed on the minefield. Oh, this is a big juicy target. If I only had some ICM next turn, this is gonna hurt. My opponent executes his turn, and his unit runs onto the minefield. Three strike mines. This unit keeps popping up, firing and then disappearing because we just can't keep a fix on it. So we see him firing, but we know he's here. This would normally be a flank shot, but it doesn't really happen in Flashpoint. Oh, one of the tanks has been driven off. Must be low on ammo or readiness. Here comes the artillery. Well, at least none of the valuable Bradleys were hit, most of the subunits. So I still have the long-range capability, but the ATGM Dragon Gunner, Dragon Squad is down. Getting creamed, and there three Bradleys die along with the Dragon. So this is pretty much an emasculated platoon now. That must be 7, almost 8 barrages, so he's got lots of artillery tubes. Another minefield detonation. This is an Tunguska, looks like. This is an surface-to-air missile unit, but it also has guns, so it's capable of ground combat. The enemies presented a few more targets for me. Unfortunately, I only have 2 artillery batteries. The multiple rocket launcher system is rearming so we'll be out of commission for another 20 minutes or so. The rocket on one of the batteries is out of ICM, so I ordered it to launch to try and throw mines here and here. Unfortunately, we aren't able to fire mixture of mine missions, ICM and high explosive. We can only fire one type at a time. So I may as well try to use up some of the mines. If I can trap them here and then trap them again here, we'll leave them right in front of the Abrams headquarters unit. My second artillery unit still has ICM ammunition. So we're going to really try to hammer this. There's 23 tanks here. With a little luck, we'll get half of them, if I'm really lucky. Unfortunately, that means these other three units are going to be unscathed. I'm going to use the mortars to try and take out some of these light-skinned Tunguska, because they just might have an effect, or they probably won't have much against tanks. So that means the tank, this tank unit and this tank unit are pretty much going to get off scot-free to roll over the engineers' bodies as they move their long move along. So all we're doing is waiting for the second line to hit them at this choke point. The enemy doesn't seem to have been made much more progress on the south, so I'm going to start rearming some of these. My mechanized infantry platoons are getting creamed by artillery up here, but there's not much I can do to disengage them. They're just going to have to die in place. The ammo's still pretty high, it's just that their readiness and morale are being sapped from being crushed under relentless artillery bombardment. Everything else is waiting at 100% and just waiting for the enemy to come through. I'm moving the cavalry scouts back up front so we can keep an eye on these barriers. The scouts are actually quite excellent in this because they are very hard to detect. The Bradleys are what normally give them away, in my opinion, and that's what gets them killed. If I could just be skulking around with a couple of cavalry scout squads, I'd be just as happy. I'd leave them a stay behind just to keep an eye on the enemy as he came through and call in artillery fire. This cavalry unit is able to watch through here, and hopefully as the enemy rolls over the bodies of the engineers, he's going to exact his price for doing so. This one, mech platoon, has already taken quite a toll off units on this location, but he's screened from this location, unfortunately. Let's begin. The SAM unit fires an anti-personnel mode. Luckily, he's not mowing down the surviving infantry squads yet. Even if the artillery doesn't kill the units, they're still drawing down their readiness and making them forced and get ready to run. Well, but he does get one. Seems to be no way to disengage the mech platoons. An enemy just sits there and just watching and destroying them with artillery. This engineer's finally had enough and he's running for his life. He's going to get shot in the back, probably, most likely, from 23 squad tanks, or two full companies of tanks. The minefield is successfully launched. Unfortunately, we've run out of mine ammunition now. Here comes the improved conventional munitions. My fingers are crossed. That's half the first company. And half the second company. So we're on target. The Bradley scores again with a chain gun. The mech platoons have had enough and they're running for their lives. They're in very exposed posture and they're going to be hit by artillery while running and they're just going to die like flies. the survival of this unit is actually quite important, I think, because it might be the only one actually spotting for this, for the artillery rounds to land on the tanks. If she dies, the artillery may not be as accurate. Finally, the mech platoon is wiped out with the death of the last Bradley. Or, not death, destruction. The American mortars reply, but no damage. They're just too light. Bradley scores another tank. The chain gun from the Bradley fires once and kills a Tunguska before displacing. The enemy seems to be making his push northward. The tow launcher moves back into position on high ground just in time to catch him on the minefield. The northern elements are all fully rearmed, and they're going to butcher him on the minefield as he's trapped for 30 minutes. A second company steps onto the minefield. The tank clears the barrier and immediately steps onto the minefield, but no subsequent detonations. They must have detected the minefield and were able to avoid it. My final cavalry has died. Now we have no eyes on the barrier. Probably what the enemy wanted. A second tank unit lands on the minefield, and one detonation is observed. The fight in the north is getting vicious. The regular line units are doing much better. Now that there's no one to observe the fall of shot, it's unlikely that there will be any significant results from the artillery on these hexes. What a waste. Those engineers died for nothing. It's just past midnight, and the enemy seems to be coming up the north road. He's hit the minefields and he's trapped upon them. But he doesn't have many tank forces here. These are all mechanized infantry. And you can kill a whole lot of mechanized infantry and not equal the value of one tank. Even though he's trapped on the minefields, he can call in artillery strikes to kill off the defending mech platoon. I have to a little worry about the headquarters getting wiped out, because if the headquarters get wiped out, I lose the ability to issue some orders, or it reduces my ability to issue orders. But I don't have anything else, so I have to throw them into the line. A quick check of the victory points sees that we've inflicted 3,600 victory point damage to the enemy. He only starts with 78, so we've got him down to about 50%. My first course of action is to allocate my artillery. And I see these targets out here. I'm hoping that by being able to see them, that I'll have more accurate results. I notice that underneath this minefield, there's one red graveyard marker, indicating that this something has come down this way and is run over this minefield and detonated a mine. So I'm hoping they're still trapped there. I'm gambling a little bit because I didn't see them go in, and I have nobody. This is a blind text. I can't observe the fire, but I'm gambling. I'm going to bring down the weight of the entire multiple launch rocket system onto this hex. I don't know if this is simulated in the game, but because the rockets are more of an area fire weapon, I don't know if they're so much directed. So hopefully, though, they seem to do better on hexes that aren't observed, as we've seen in the south. Even though the hex is not under observation by one of my units, they still seem to deliver quite a bit of damage. I'm saving the artillery for the ones that I can actually see the target, but the enemy is doing a really good job. I know it's not intentional, but it works out that way. He's killing off all the units within sight of it, and thereby dropping back into invisibility, which is really helping him. The visibility has improved. We'll hit Control L, and we can see that as night falls, it's clearing, and my thermal sensors are finally able to see at a distance. So we haven't seen anyone come across the middle. I'm preparing my units to move out to reinforce the center and northern flank. Not everything. I'm going to be leaving still some to cover it, but if they come down through this corridor, I've got an anti-tank team and a mechanized platoon, not to mention an air defense unit, try to cover the ground to make this a murderous entrance. Here we go. The enemy smoke dissipates quickly. I think it came from mostly his mortars. I don't know if it's totally accurate, but I think that the heavier the caliber of the gun, the longer lasting the smoke is, or at least that's my experience. And the enemy here has a lot of guns. He's hit every single target that's visible multiple times. He's already driven off the headquarters unit. And looks to blast his way. He's tried to send units up through here, and we stopped him. Well, at least the headquarters unit has managed to evade successfully. The mech platoon stays put and gets creamed. We'll see how our mortars do with a unit trapped on the barriers. Here comes the heavy 155mm artillery. Only two hits, only two kills. Quite weak. we'll see how our rocket fire does on a blind hex. Not as well as I hoped. We took fire from this hex, so there's obviously another unit making its way northward, or to reinforce. Wait, maybe he's waiting for one of these barriers to be cleared. A second salvo from the multiple launch rocket system. Four explosions. Well, four squads or vehicles are down. We continue to punch the motorized rifle company caught in the barrier. The mortars deliver their final salvo. And kill a mechanized infantry squad. The surviving the heavy machine gun, he continues to take out enemy squads. Even the headquarters unit that's running manages to fire back and take out an armored personnel carrier. Finally, the machine gun squad is wiped out. The enemy continues his attack and seems to be approaching this corridor, but we've lost track of him. My orders are I'm going to pull back this cavalry unit. He's been out here for 2.5 hours, 25% of the time, and nothing's been happening here, so we might be able to use his firepower of 2 Bradleys. I'll reposition him here to help cover this entrance, and then I'm preparing to move my units northward. I've issued them their paths, but they haven't been activated yet. What I've done is, in order to get past the 30 minute delay in orders, I've issued the orders, but I put a waypoint in here and I've delayed it 180 minutes. That's maximum possible. When I want them to be start moving, I'll just take this. The easy way to get around it is to just delete this waypoint, and then they start moving instantaneously rather than trying to replot it at that time and wait and being penalized another 30 minutes just sitting there doing nothing. So that's one way to get around the decision cycle problem. My SAMs and headquarter unit continue to move back and forth. They're running low at readiness, but, well, it's better than dying. Unfortunately, all my artillery seems to be resupplying. I've run out of it, and the enemy is spotted and heading down this path, unfortunately with nothing to do to them. So we're kind of in a bind. This is an anti-tank unit, an enemy anti-tank unit, and these anti-tank units are only worth what? About 7 lousy victory points each. So this unit's worth a total of 35. Unfortunately, if he comes up on the Abrams and manages to kill it, his 35 points in exchange for a 126-point battle tank is not equitable. Even if he's just killing the armored personnel carrier accompanying the tanks, it's still a bad trade-off. So I'm going to try to take him out with mortar fire. It's with a lightly skinned vehicle like this, we actually have a chance. But look at all these juicy targets up here. We just can't serve them. Here we go. But the enemy has plenty of artillery with which to do unto me. And he's dropped a minefield on top of me. Good way to use the mines, at least. If he's still dropping more smoke, we can tell he's got more forces advancing upon this position down this road. As my units feverishly try to resupply, they keep getting hammered, and they're now in more exposed posture. They're in covered posture, not quite exposed, but they're still in covered posture, not the same as in the dug-in posture. My artillery arrives late and is wasted on another empty hex. But so is his. The Abrams takes her first victim. But at this range, there's just no way to kill them fast enough. The Bradley opens up and kills an anti-tank unit. The lightly skinned anti-tank unit is wiped out. Unfortunately, he's already known the positions of my three defending units. Now they're going to get a dose of that artillery. The Dragon Gunner waits and ambushes a mechanized unit coming through. He was just sitting here holding. A great sacrifice, even though the anti-tank unit got wiped out, he got valuable intelligence on my positions. So well done for cheap, very cheap cost. His relentless pressure prevents my anti-tank unit from actually rearming and reloading fully. She can't get a 30-minute cycle in order to fully resupply, so every time she gets spotted, she gets chased out of there by binoculars. The enemy advances into the smoke and immediately kills an M1 Abrams with a useless anti-tank team worth 5 victory points. They just took out 156 victory points worth of tank. That's a 3,000% return on investment. Good job. Setting up my orders. I've got my artillery. I'm going to try to fire the 155mm howitzers into these two. It seems a lot of effort to kill, but it seems like my artillery is pretty useless too. Even in moving in the open, I'm unable to actually kill weak infantry moving in the open. So I've got a few. Maybe I can stop them here. Too late to save the tanks. Both batteries are going to concentrate, as well as the mortars. The multiple launch rocket system is going to try to take out this one exposed in the open. This, my mechanized infantry unit, is so low in readiness and ammo, it's probably going to die in the next turn with a barrage of artillery, but I don't have any better targets. I'm repositioning a couple of my, trying to at least get them moving. The air defense unit, Vulcan, is actually going to have some anti-ground capability, or anti-infantry hopefully, so by placing him in this hex, he can cover the approach a little bit, and also the mechanized infantry platoon will be covering from the hills. So hopefully, if he's coming up this direction for this victory point location, we can get them at a range of maybe 2 or 3. That's my best hope, at least. Once this tank gets wiped out, we're going to have no eyes on the situation and be blind. As I stated previously, this mechanized infantry unit had 3 waypoints. By deleting the one with the 180-minute delay, right now we don't suffer the 30-minute penalty for orders. We just start moving right away. Here we go. As expected, my mech infantry platoon is going to get hammered. I expected to die before the artillery arrives, so I may as well. I need the unguided, I guess, the unspotted rocket artillery. As one move, I've taken out all the subordinate units from underneath the tank unit, because when it dies, I'm hoping that it will not reduce the number of orders I have that I can issue. If I had 5 or 10 units underneath it, I think, not positive, but I think that it will penalize me more if I had subordinate units underneath when it dies. So this is kind of a practice I use when headquarters are about to be destroyed. Same I did with one headquarters up here. It's only one Bradley left, so I have removed any subordinate units from it so that the chain of command isn't broken when it dies. There goes the command headquarters unit again, running from the binocular. My rocket artillery goes in. Not much damage for such a powerful force. It's supposed to erase the hex, not just scratch it. See, even with them moving in the open, I don't expect them to actually kill it. Nothing! 155mm barrage returns nothing! Twice! Along with mortars. Nothing! And my mechanized platoon is wiped out. The headquarters unit is getting pummeled because he's got a spotter. I'm actually quite surprised he didn't waste more artillery on it instead of killing some hapless infantry unit in the north. But the more that falls on empty woods or dead infantry, the less that falls on my tank. Yes, 150mm, 55mm artillery on an open target in the open, can't kill it. I'm glad that the artillery managed to shift fire and notice where the enemy had gone into. That's a nice improvement in 2.05. Now we see they'd actually be able to hit something. I have to be careful about my engineer unit. It's a linchpin for all these command units out here. So if he dies, with all these subordinates underneath him, it's going to cause problems. So instead of having 17 orders to issue, I might end up with only 10 or less. He's really bringing it. Even if he can't destroy anything, if it doesn't destroy anything, he'll keep it down so low that they won't be able to fire back. That's not a bad strategy. With low readiness and low morale, he'll start bugging out and then he'll be shot in the back. Target in the open, unable to kill it. The tank units advanced, but we would kill the infantry. This one's doing much better. Three armored personnel carriers and their subunits. Finally. Six more, actually 12 more light-skinned units. Six armored personnel carriers and their subunits. That was a good shooting. They must have just moved into the hex. An enemy located at 3216. We can't mark it, but we'll just have to try to remember it. Right there, beautiful. Where can he go? Unfortunately, I just used up all my rocket artillery. We'll have to remember him next time. Even running, the headquarters unit manages to take out an infantry squad. My cavalry starts to pull out. I guess I'm going to need every gun hand I have. The enemy has displaced one hex. Excellent. Just by firing on the enemy doesn't have to see where what's there. He hasn't detected my headquarters unit, but by seeing the line of fire come in, he can watch from the replay and he'll be able to target more artillery. I suspect that he's going to try to wipe out this unit next turn. Another tank has appeared coming down the road, but that's no use to another Abrams die, so this lousy 8 armored personnel carrier survives. Not much you can do, since it only has a machine gun on it. And she'll get shot. Now that she turns to run, she'll be destroyed and shot in the back. Oh, looks like the enemy's thrown a minefield up here. Gotta have to remember that. And a minefield in the middle of this victory point location. It's too bad that there's no function in the game where we just mark. We know they're here, but there's nothing. I can't do anything about to try to remember it other than making a note of it somewhere else off the game. And that shouldn't happen, right? We should be in the game. We should be able to know which areas are off limits. That's good. He's trying to restrict the movement of my SAM units from north to south, which I've been doing. I've kept them moving simply to keep them from being destroyed. The moment I stop, they'll be hammered flat because the radar just cannot turn it off. So when they run out of gas and stop to resupply, I expect them to be creamed. Wow. Amazing how the enemy's able to find my tank as well. Oh yes, he fired last turn, so he knows it's here, and he's creaming it for with artillery. There goes the headquarters unit. I'm glad I moved all the subordinate units out of it first to prevent the enemy from taking away too many commands. And he's dropped another minefield here. He's in an ambush position. Looks like he's the one that ends up being ambushed. What a waste, huh? Tank's trying to kill a stupid infantry unit. He reveals himself and then finally gets wiped out for it. So this one infantry unit has cost me about 600 points for in return, maybe 5 or 10 points of infantry. That's a just a crappy return. Can't stop it. AI fires the tanks wherever they want, and they try to take out the infantry unit, but that's just a dumb move. Better to have let them through. We do get some haha at this. The enemy advanced onto his own position and now is running into his own artillery. That's the mark of a good, in real life, I guess that's a mark of good infantry troops is if you send them in right under your own barrage and are willing to take casualties from it. As I issue my orders, I think I'm hoping that I've stopped his penetration from the center, or he's decided to go in a different route. So I'm going to try to resupply this engineer, decimated engineer platoon while seems to be a lull. He's at 99% ammo, but I want his readiness level up higher in case he does come back through this way and forces him off the target. So I taking a risk here. He might show up. If he shows up with his combat binoculars, he'll chase him out of here and force him to retreat. But I think I've got the well. It's fairly well covered with my reconnaissance platoon and the other surviving engineer unit. The visibility is not good, but between the two of them, I think I have enough early warning to see the enemy should he decide to come up this route. I'm going to move my Bradley up here to try to put a stopper in this. In this hole that the enemy has forced through, I will go into assault mode and hold here. He's going to die a miserable death, but if he survives long enough, perhaps he can actually call in some artillery fire on the enemy that we've had sporadic contact with as he comes down this road. We have three contacts. One is a lousy infantry, couple of infantry squads surviving here, squatting on the remains of my headquarters unit. Another armored personnel carrier and a SAM unit. These are worthless units, absolutely worthless units that you could kill them all day long and it wouldn't equate to a single tank or, look at that, 5 points. Or armored personnel carrier. Unless I can kill the tanks, it won't matter. Our current situation is we have them at about 4,300 in losses. That's just about 50 out of a total of 7,800. So that makes it About 56%. That's pretty good. If I can kill a few more tanks, we can force this into sudden death and win the game that way. But we have to find the tanks. Those are the only things that are worth any value. These infantry are 5 and 10 points, 5 and 10 points. You could wipe them entire thing out and not make a difference. The enemy has dropped mines here, 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 and here. Unfortunately, I can't mark them on the map, so all I can do is try to memorize them. I've taken a screenshot of it, and I've marked it on a JPEG somewhere else, but it really would be nice to have it in a game that you could just put in here, avoid this area if possible. I have rerouted my SAM units and headquarters units to stay away from them, but I suspect the enemy's going to be dropping lots more mines. He's been trying to silence my, or at least prevent them from moving. He has successfully prevented this infantry unit. See, we managed to sneak, we'll sneak hopefully right through here, unless the AI decides to do something silly and drive me right over a mine. I'm hoping not. I really am hoping not. But I should have enough movement points to get me past here. Same with my reinforcing air defense platoon, my Vulcans. I have enough waypoints so I can actually move around, unless he drops the mine here next time, which would be a good point for him, and then he'd hammer me, or I'd run into a minefield. So he's doing a good job trying to restrict my range of motion. My two platoons and the headquarters managed to kill off his anti-tank platoon here, but we revealed ourselves, so I expect these to be destroyed in very short time. I'm moving up an engineer platoon. It's only got very limited area. It's got a 50 caliber machine gun, and the engineer squads have almost nothing in weapons. So in close range, they could be okay. I'm going to use it to try to plug this gap a little bit, so as he comes through here, even at a range of one, the engineers should be able to give good account of themselves before they die. My artillery is going to hammer up on the exposed ones. I've decided not to go after the ephemeral, the contacts that come through here that flicker on and flicker off, and I are lost in an instant. I'll try to hit the ones I can actually see something. In the south, I'm fairly convinced the enemy won't be coming through here, so I'm going to use my weak cavalry section, reconnaissance section, to cover this gap from here. He's got good fields of fire, long range with his Bradley TOWs, and chain gun, but not much. There's only four of them, so they're easily wiped out, but I'll have him hold here to lend his fire support to plug this gap. I'm leaving our other cavalry scout has moved ahead and is able, and we can see that he's seen nothing here with his enhanced sensors, so there's nothing on the wire. What I'm going to try to do is I'm going to move him into the gap here and have him hold. We'll see there's two waypoints here, and the first waypoint, we'll look at the waypoint here. It says 180 minute delay. Wow, that's a 3-hour delay right before we get there, but I've done it this way so that I can simply take this waypoint and delete it. Now my scout platoon or scout section will move here immediately, not without waiting a three-hour delay. Once it gets here, I will be able to try and pull out this engineer platoon and maybe reinforce the north or center, because we don't need, even though it's a very weak amount, it's still more firepower. The enemy disappeared into the center here somewhere, and I've got two Bradleys going to be looking for him after they refuel. But between my Bradleys here and Bradleys here, I'm hoping that if he decides to come through, I'll have one tank platoon plus maybe an anti-tank, a headquarters, and possibly, well, I'll even keep the mechanized infantry platoon here. This other mechanized infantry platoon is also holding, but we'll probably be moving him northwards. Maybe this one will go first because it has further distance to go. I don't think the enemy's going to be coming through here. I'm hoping that the cavalry in this spot and a fire and a tow launcher here might be enough to hold him back, as well as a mech platoon here and possibly one here, and a tank platoon. That's quite a bit. That's quite a bit of firepower for him to try to force the entrance. But I don't have a place for my mechanized infantry platoon to actually go. The best spots are already taken, occupied, but I'm waiting for one of these to die. When he hits it with the artillery, it's going to die very quickly. And I'll probably be using him as a replacement for one of these destroyed units, as well as these. Notice I've already got them on the move. I've assigned them with the waypoint editor, and I've got them with 180-minute delay. So the second I delete this one, he's going to go zooming off to the wherever I have assigned him. He's a little bit more... He's in covered posture instead of the more protected dug-in posture, but that's a sacrifice I'll have to make. I'm willing to take as a risk in order to get them avoid that 30-minute decision delay penalty. Here we go. All my units give themselves away trying to engage a useless infantry unit. Now we're just... I expect all four of them to be hammered flat with artillery next turn. Very good decoy. Send them out front, and I just can't stop. And I can't hit anything either. It'd be one thing if I actually killed them once, but to be once the infantry goes to ground, it's very hard to dig them out. We're dropping artillery and mortars into the area, trying to destroy him. He's not even spotting us. He's spotting us indirectly. Simply by following back the lines of fire, he can know where my units are. One infantry squad is killed, and he's finally wiped out. But it's not going to save. He's going to kill nearly 1,000 points worth of tanks, plus another 200 to 500 points worth of infantry carriers, simply by existing. That's just disgusting, and there's nothing I can do to stop wasting artillery, wasting efforts on him. Our artillery in the north does a little bit, but kill just a single infantry squad. He's at a high point. He's probably using it the same reason I'm using it, to spot for fire or to call in artillery. He's doing it. He's using them as very expensive artillery forward observers, which I wouldn't fault him for. That's a good tactic. There go my units. I've seen any more mines dropped in the area, so that's a relief. Hopefully he's running out of the damn things. By putting him up on such a high unit, my sensors are better, I think, so I'm able to see him and keep calling in the artillery. It's a drawn out process, but I think we should be able to destroy this light skinned unit, infantry unit, sooner or later. It just takes an incredible number of missions. That's what, 4 or 5 missions already on that infantry squad, and we still haven't wiped her out yet. We've got him trapped on the minefield, but we're unable to kill him. Here comes the 4th mission, I think. Maybe even 5th. One squad at a time, we finally annihilate him. Well, that's a great spotting point for a whole area. If the weather improves any better, but my thermal sensors are doing a better job than his visuals or his thermals. We finally engage the SAM unit caught on the wire. A tank unit has emerged from the woods and is sneaking around the north. It's good that the enemy has selected a very secretive path. He's trying to go through the north to avoid the fire from the south, which is pretty good, because his hex is pretty much hidden from these armored personnel carriers waiting for him. But he hasn't wiped out my tank unit yet, and my tank unit does get a shot at him, but of course misses him in open ground. He's dropped another mine here, trying to tie up my forces, and he's hammering the surviving mechanized platoon members. They've revealed themselves, trying to engage a silly SAM unit, and now they're going to get killed. I'm glad I've delayed my departure here, because he looks like he's making an effort to cross the wire in the center with more armored personnel carriers. The difference is, the armored personnel carriers, these are worth maybe 10 or 15 points. 10 points for the carrier and maybe 5 points for the squad inside. Now, look at him. He's killing off my armored personnel carriers because we couldn't kill him in the open. Now he's in cover and he's going to just destroy whatever else he sees. He spotted these as ready already, so he's marking them as targets for destruction by the artillery next turn. We do make him pay with a couple of tanks, but this... Oh, three tanks... That's not bad. These 15 units right here, this is worth maybe a total of, 100 points worth. That's like two tanks worth. Same with these, but they take an awful lot of killing. I've got my engineers stacked up with my other engineers, or my reconnaissance scouts, and this is going to be all in one hex. What's one prime target for artillery? That's too bad. I wanted to move them in and then switch out, but I'm glad they're at least still in the area to cover. We've got one tank surviving here, and he's managed to kill the Bradley from my headquarters unit. He's now in open ground, and we have nothing with which to do on to him. This Bradley unit is going to move to cover, and maybe we'll get him with a TOW missile. Another the mechanized platoon up here is getting hit. Lost another Bradley. Wow, he's really throwing out the mines. So we got to mark this one as another mine unit. So we got here, and there, our artillery just stupidly runs right into it. Way to go. Total idiots. Thanks for committing suicide, boys. We start taking losses among the engineers. He's just got too much firepower when you have seven of them there, all stacked up. But we are taking a toll while he's trapped on the wire. The armored personnel carriers take, as they're caught in open ground, they get hammered by his tank unit. They don't return fire, they just die. The armored personnel, the Bradleys in the north, get hit again by artillery fire for revealing themselves. So we're going to lose, for his 50 points, we've already lost one Bradley. We're going to lose another 100 points worth of Bradleys. That's a 300% return on his investment. Good job. We just can't stop him from firing. Yeah. And we can't kill this one here either. So he sails a tank right through here and spots everything for his artillery to be destroyed later. Now I'm in a quandary. What do I pull out? Will this thrust be backed up by tanks, or is it just an armored personnel carrier attack? With an armored personnel carrier attack, I can leave the air defense unit here, because he's got a pretty high rate of fire and he can cover this entrance fairly well. And I can pull out some of this and try to reinforce the north, because I expect these to be exterminated in the next turn. In my orders phase, I can see that the enemy thrust, the only ones I've detected, are coming through here. I know he's got some tanks coming through here, but I haven't seen them yet. And my infantry mechanized platoon is almost at its final spot. But I do expect the enemy to be wiping out these three, maybe even this fourth unit very soon with his artillery. It's interesting to note, I have 14 order I can allocate to my units this turn. With the destruction of the tank headquarter company, I've lost three orders. I was at 17. So even with no subordinate units assigned to the tank company when it was wiped out, I still lose the ability to generate three orders. So that's quite significant. But looking at the command and control cycle, we see that the enemy is actually having a very short command and control cycle, 16, 17, and 19 minutes. His is actually getting shorter as I destroy his units, which is kind of odd, as I wipe out his headquarters along the way. And more distressingly, this every time he gets an orders phase, he's allowed to reallocate his artillery. So every 16 minutes or so, he can allocate a new barrage of artillery to smash my positions, which is terrible because he gets to fire twice as many as I do, almost, with my 25-minute decision cycle. Peculiar, but that's the way it goes. The orders I've given are, I don't have much here other than hold the position and die valiantly, continue to reinforce in the north and resupply. This Bradley will probably be wiped out this turn from artillery. My SAMs are continue to move back and forth, drawing enemy fire. I've elected, now that I've had a choice to reinforce, I've elected not to pull out just yet, because I need to see if this attack is going to be supported by tanks or anything else. Unfortunately, my engineers are all stacked up here, so they're making a very juicy target for enemy artillery. The engineers plus the two surviving scout members, that's just bad luck. That, well, maybe good luck that that I haven't pulled out any other units yet. I've got my artillery coming down, and I'm going to try to wipe out this unit on the road with a barrage of rockets. This unit, I've also got two artillery fire missions assigned to it from the 155mm howitzers, and I'm going to try to catch this unit on the wire. He's not going anywhere, so I'm trying to get my first two barrages onto this advancing unit, because he'll probably be moving on to the minefield next. But this one's trapped on the wire, so he's not going anywhere. I'll assign my third one to him, same with the others. My nearly wiped out mortar company will do the same. We know that there's mines here, and I think he's dropping some more along in the middle. I still haven't decided to pull out the rest of my platoons. If I can hold back that attack here, I will release my mechanized platoons to reinforce these positions, which are soon to be exterminated. That's the best term, exterminated. Now, I've been quite parsimonious with my orders, even though I have 14, and I can't even use them all up because there's not 14 things I want to do with this turn. I could, now, this air defense platoon, or Vulcan, was going to be used in the anti-surface mode, or anti-infantry mode, and moved up, but I've decided that I'm not going to move it yet, because he's the only one, we'll use Control L, he's the only one that's got some line of sight on here, so if the enemy decides to cross the barrier and then duck into the woods here, he might be the only one that can actually bring fire upon them. So I think I'm going to hold him back a little while longer before releasing him northwards. If he hits the barriers and mines, I'm still going to, should cost him 20 to 30 minutes before he can cross them, so I don't have to make any hasty decisions with these that are preparing to move. With the Vulcan, I could just order the Vulcan to hold and stop its movement. It was issued a while ago, and it's about ready to move out. But I don't want to be wasting orders. I never will waste an order on it. So instead of wasting an order to tell it to hold, I'm just going to delete the waypoint, and the unit drops back into hold automatically. I have extra, but it's always in my opinion, best practice not to waste them. Always use them parsimoniously. Here we go. The Bradley starts off well, killing an AP armored personnel carrier with a TOW missile and another one. But we're not killing the subunit with him. He's already obviously deployed and is advancing on foot. A number of tanks and other vehicles have appeared right where I should have dropped a minefield. That's my loss. Oh, and it's a SAM unit. In the south, we've killed a couple more on the wire, But he's now advanced into the minefield, and we've lost one of our engineer squads. The enemy is trapped on the wire and engaged with machine gun fire. Mortars drop on the armored personnel carrier caught on the wire. The heavy artillery drops into the armored personnel or motorized rifle company in the minefield. No result. In the open, and no result. 2nd barrage. Claims a couple of infantry squads. The rockets prove the most successful, one of each. A SAM launcher and tanks have approached where this kill zone, this death zone, has been detected, but we haven't seen any more of them. I was hoping to drop a minefield here, but didn't have a chance. I used the rockets instead to hammer this motorized rifle company. And another one, infantry squad dies. Subunit. Here comes a second rocket barrage. Only one more rifle company is hit. We really need to wipe this one off the map. And it's exterminated, thank goodness. In the north, the tanks have turned northwards and are exposed to the remnants of this tank platoon. If we can only get into action, they should take out a few tanks, hopefully. They do fire, but miss. Here comes the enemy artillery response. The scouts are wiped out. He's attacking my mechanized platoon with mines, and he gets a couple of strikes. Three, easily. Even in a dug-in position, he's punished. See, the enemy just saw me. Even though I'd wiped him out, the enemy saw me moving in this direction and guessed ahead where he might be. The other mechanized platoon that was spotted by the now deceased motor rifle company is eating a whole barrage of artillery, heavy stuff, judging by the sound of it. He's got a whole lot to do unto me. All he has to do is find the target, and then they're destroyed. The engineers take another salvo. There may be only one surviving armored personnel. There's two. But it's enough to provide intelligence for the rest of his group. One sees it, everyone sees it. It's just smashed heavily. And the enemy is dropping artillery on where this motorized rifle company used to be. So not everything managed to shift fire. More tanks join the stack already there. Gosh, if I only had a minefield or more rockets to drop on this. The tanks just fire away, miss it. Tanks in the open. Terrible shooting. The mech platoon eats another artillery barrage. Looks like some were able to shift onto their new location and others were not. The three surviving engineer units, subrunners? Yes, are hanging on by their fingernails. I'm hoping that because there's nobody to spot for this artillery fire, that it's less effective. Nope. Still kills another Bradley, it looks like. Oh, no, it killed the dismounts. Caught in the open, can't even kill a single tank. The engineer, take two hits. Both armored personnel carriers are wiped out from the headquarters company. I've already removed all the subordinate units. Wow, look at that stack. What a juicy target if anyone could actually would open a fire on it. The mechanized rifle platoon or company, it's on its last one more, maybe. The mech platoon may survive, but it'll be pretty much combat ineffective until it rearms and refuels and rests, if it survives. He's bringing a lot of artillery on her. And another dies. He's at 50% strength right now. The engineers are at 25% strength. The mech platoon is going to be exterminated before he even has a chance to engage the tanks. There it goes. It's at 50% down to 50% level. And my mech platoons refused to engage. Finally, we take out another worthless SAM launcher. I just can't understand the targeting priorities. You got tanks in the open, and they fire at the SAM launcher. We do get a tank from the anti-tank platoon, and another SAM launcher for 5 points. Yahoo! The tanks move off to the northwest. It's on a high ground and it's fairly open, so we're trying to catch a few more kills out here. At least we're getting pure tank kills now. And he's gone. He's out again. Holy cow, he must be moving. Look at that speed at which he traversed this. He got one shot and he was gone already. More tanks follow up. But here comes the arty. Well, they deserve everything they're getting. They failed to kill the targets in the middle. Now they're going to eat it. That's justice. Will they survive long enough to engage this tank as it comes through? That's to be seen. And we still haven't been able to kill off this last armored personnel carrier. So he's going to spot for more artillery next turn. Again, they get what they deserve. They failed to kill it. Now they have to pay the price. Here it comes. And being attacked by mines in a dug-in position. I guess I'm going to try the same gambit next turn. I'll be launching mines at these, since the artillery doesn't seem to be doing much. Even in a dug-in position, the Bradleys are getting creamed. Now the light thin-skinned anti-tank tow launchers are going to get their own pasting. Yep, they just can't stand up to artillery fire. And right into the range of the two surviving Bradleys. He's trying to occupy the high ground again with reconnaissance units till he can spot. Good plan. I just don't have enough artillery to take them all out. So by spotting for him, he pretty much dominates this northern area. I can't move without being seen and eating his artillery barrage. And he's got plenty of artillery. And he's wasting up all his mines. He's got lots of mines, so he's just using them quite prodigiously. Good for him. He's not paid to take home the ammunition, so he might as well use it all up. I've used up most of my mines already. Only mines left are on the multiple launch rocket system. And she's too busy firing rockets to try and kill these stacks, but we're going to have to start firing those mines off next. Maybe she can trap one of these units and then kill it off with subsequent rocket launches. Only one engineer squad remains. And it's exterminated. Good for them. They got their just desserts. The enemy has put me in quite a situation. He's occupied one of my victory point locations, and he's already knocked me down to from a strategic decisive victory down to 73%, so I only have a marginal success at that. By one taking one location, he's really reduced me by two levels of victory. The Bradleys here are out of ammo, out low on morale. They're going to die this turn. And they're surrounded by SAM launchers and nearly a full company of tanks. They're going to die. In the north, I've got SAM launchers. Now I've got as he was moving back and forth, now we're going to head the other direction. At least with their death, he will use up some of the enemy ammunition, hopefully. My headquarters company is still running around. My task force herd high headquarters is still running around and keeping his artillery guessing which direction we're going. But at readiness level of 11%, it looks like this is probably the turn where they're going to stop moving, and the second they stop moving, they're going to die. All my artillery is currently resupplying. Now, the tanks I had previously slated to reinforce, looks like this one's going to be wiped out pretty soon. Yep, 15% morale. I can't even go into resupply because it's just going to get hit again. At least in dug-in posture, it's a little bit more protected than the covered posture of a resupply operation. There's two headquarters squads remaining. They've got, we'll take a look at Control F, they've got no armament. It's unarmed. There's supposed to be something here, but headquarters, looks like it's less than 15 meter range and four. So unless they're overrun, they're worthless. My machine gun company here is set to run, but he's facing T-72 tanks. He might kill the armored personnel carrier, but there's no chance he'll kill a tank. So he's going to die probably next turn. The anti-tank platoon, the tow launcher, already suffered a loss, and the enemy knows where it is, so he'll probably die next turn. The headquarters company here has no tow launcher. The Bradley accompanying it is already dead, so the M113 really has no range of effective fire. It's a 50 caliber machine gun, unlikely to take out anything major. So this one's pretty, this is an empty shirt as well. So he's pretty much knocked out anything I have to cover this area. And these two, the last two Bradleys I have in the at this location are going to die soon. He's also picked up the engineer squad. This is the combat engineers HQ section, which was providing command and control for the northern area. Because he's spotted it with the little, you see the little white dot from his high location, she's going to die. And they're very weak. There's only two armored personnel carriers and a couple of headquarters squads. So I've removed all the subordinate elements from it in expectation of her extermination. This has left my units in the isolated on the road. They're trying to rearm, trying to resupply, but they're outside range of the HQ. I've retasked my mechanized platoon to head up. Instead of heading into a blocking position, they've already gone past. There's nothing to block. Now we're going to head in here. Maybe we can actually be able to see, catch one of their secondary echelon as it moves into the gap. In the south, it's a good thing we already had a tank move pre-planned. You had the three waypoints, and we had a delay of 180 minutes just to keep them in motion. So now, this is a high point here. I'm hoping the tank here will be able to cover or bring fire upon any movement from these tank units. Can't see it, but at least in the future, it might bring them under attack if we can. So by deleting the waypoint, this tank should be able to move right away. Got to be careful. We remember there were mines that were here, here, and here. So we should be avoiding the mine barrier. There's mines here, here, and here. And this should avoid those mine barriers. The pre-planned armored personnel, the mech platoon movement, looks like this one's going to be wiped out. So we have the same point here, the waypoint editor. We had it at 180 minute delay, and now we'll just delete that waypoint. I've got my fingers crossed that it's not going to do something stupid and jump on this minefield, and that it's actually going to go past it and then around. But you never know with the AI, so all we can do is hope. My other mech platoon is going to move out and replace this headquarters unit, which I expect to be extinguished very soon. We had the same point, we had the same technique before. We have a 180 minute delay, and now we'll delete it, and I'm hoping it'll avoid the minefield. There's still an armored personnel carrier somewhere out right here, probably. Survive, we can't see it. So I'm going to keep the air defense platoon on hold here, as well as the anti-tank tow launchers. He's field of fire. He's still covering this approach in case there should be a need. I'm leaving him. I'm the cavalry reconnaissance section will cover with him. The survivors, well, this one's probably going to be, they'll keep firing until he counts up the explosions to know this one's destroyed. So I don't expect him to be around much longer, but I'll have one headquarters section, tow section, another headquarters section covering this approach, and one tank platoon and another headquarters section here. So I think that should be enough to still protect this gap, and I'm moving the two mech platoons up north. I'm a little leery about what's happening here because I knew there were some tank units or enemy units that had disappeared into the gap, and I haven't seen them since. So I don't know if they're trying to sneak through here and put eyeballs on this area in order to call in the artillery. So I've got two surviving Bradleys. We're going to move through this area, and I've got them at a 183-hour delay. So once they hit the waypoint one, there will be a 3-hour delay before going to waypoint two. This is my technique so that in case I want to move quickly. That way they can scout through this area and make sure that there aren't any threats. As this reconnaissance platoon has it covered up to there. And then if there aren't any threats here, I'll continue to move it off and hopefully to reinforce or to cover the southern approach. I've been quite stingy with the number of orders. I'm trying to be as conservative as possible. I still only use 6 out of 14, so I've got plenty to use, but I'm still trying to preserve them in case I need a lot of them later on. Here we go. As predicted, the first Bradley dies immediately from a hail of direct fire from the T-72. Oh, and they scatter as well. But are replaced by three more. Looks like they were on a deliberate move. So they are running as well. Maybe we can shoot one in the back for them. The enemy continues to blast the engineers. We are already in their shallow graves. We've cleared the minefield on here. As another Bradley dies. It's dropped into automatic resupply mode, so it's in covered posture instead of the more protected hold dug-in posture. It just speeds its destruction. And the tow launcher is being attacked by minefields. Way more effective than any artillery could be. But it instantly clears the minefield as well. Sam on Sam. That's kind of an interesting matchup. The enemy has a significant force behind my lines at Oberthausen. They've disappeared into the north here. My heavy machine gun unit continues to fight it out with a tank unit, a headquarters unit, most likely. We've got to keep note of this. The SAM unit has retreated into this hex. Now the machine gun is getting a pounding from artillery. As noted earlier, my engineer headquarters, I guess, platoon, has drawn the attention of artillery, and both armored personnel carriers are destroyed. The SAM unit is serving its purpose. It's distracting the enemy and drawing artillery fire. It's a very cheap unit anyway. It keeps the enemy occupied, keeps him from hitting something that actually shoots back. There is a slight problem. This Chaparral was seen engaging the enemy SAM unit. And it doesn't really have anything for anti-surface operations. But in this version, 2.05, it seems to be a bug that allows for this to happen. And supposedly it'll be fixed in 2.06. SAM units are not supposed to be engaging other land units. There are no machine guns or cannon aboard or grenade launchers, anything of the sort. The headquarters unit is on the verge of extinction. The tow unit continues to try and engage the reconnaissance units on top the hill without much success. The engineer unit is finally wiped out, headquarters. Looks like the enemy is trying to attack this machine gun unit with mines. Is that correct? No, maybe not. So SAM unit draws another barrage. Run, rabbit, run. Looks like the enemy unit has moved off, but he still sees us, and notice the little white dot indicates that we're still spotted, and he's still drawing artillery fire. The enemy tries to anticipate where my SAM unit is going to be moving and fires a leading shot but misses. That's a good job. The machine gun unit hangs on for dear life amid barrage salvo after salvo of artillery. There's another misdirected SAM unit, but notice he's not hitting any of the ones he previously detected, which I thought he would have been prudent to hammer these positions more, because obviously they don't have enough crosses on here to justify a destroyed unit. But if he's going to... And the machine gun unit finally dies. But if he's willing to give a respite during this lull, that's fine with me. More desultory tow fire against the top of the hill. So it looks like there's probably a couple of reconnaissance vehicles up here. He can't see me, but he should be seeing where that fire is coming from. So, oh, we do get one of the recon vessel or vehicles. Or squads. Unlikely it's a squad because this is a tow round. So it's most likely anti-vehicle and it's not against a soft target. Here's my orders phase. Even though the enemy has destroyed another HQ unit and reduced me to a number of 12 maximum orders I can give, I still only use 5 of them, so I'm pretty far ahead of the curve. I'm using half of what I actually need. In the south, I've decided that I'm going my plug here, the mechanized platoon, is holding the barrier. But plugging up this hole. He's been hit by artillery quite a bit and is really low on the morale and readiness, but he's resupplied with ammo. If the enemy continues to hit it, then I'm going to, it will die. But unless and until the enemy comes through here and decides to take it out, he'll remain the cork stopper in the valve. This one hasn't started moving yet. I'm going to leave the air defense unit here to provide anti-personnel and ground cover, but I'm going to take the tow launcher. I'm sending it up. I need it in the north because this is where the armor penetration is, and I need it much more than in the south. Looks like the south, if there's anything here, well, the last ones that have been through here have been armored personnel, infantry only, so it's not much use here. Could take out armored personnel carriers, but I've got the headquarters unit, a cavalry unit, and a tank unit, and another headquarters unit still covering, and maybe these will survive long enough, but we don't know. So I'm going to send the tool launcher up to give it some long-range capability from this hex, since this has only an armored personnel carrier that has really no reach. I previously had a plan to move, so we had the 3-hour delay. Now that if I take it off, delete the waypoint, this thing should take off like a bat out of hell. Trying to avoid the minefield here. Again, got my fingers crossed that we're not going to be stupid enough. The AI won't just force me to run onto it, so we'll try to avoid that. I've got my mech platoon from last turn. I've decided instead of repositioning it into the center, I'm going to have to send it up off and try to retake that position over in Obertshausen. The only way to do it is to force it with infantry. And so I'm taking the roundabout route to try to avoid avoid detection from this area. He's got vehicles here, and he's probably got more coming through. If I can stay down low and get in here before I make my final assault approach. My other tank platoon, or mechanized platoon, is going to come and plug up this hole that left by these, by this departing, or this Bradley mechanized platoon that was forced out of here from losses. We still have two Bradleys, but that's not enough, so I'm going to reinforce it in case he still wants to make a push through here. This could also provide some type of fire if it actually fires. So that's where my one reinforcement goes. My other reinforcing tank platoon is going to head right here. This is a high point that we should be able to at least I'm hoping that they'll engage anything that should he decide to make his second move for this victory point location. So he'll cover while the mechanized platoon makes her approach to retake this victory point. The SAM continues to run and draw attention. Good, as long as the enemy fires on it. The tow launcher is going to keep trying to fire on this reconnaissance. It's unlikely to be an infantry unit, mainly because the tow launcher should be only engaging vehicles. Now, in 2.05, yes, it does allow, the game allows tow missiles to engage soft targets such as infantry and squads, but that should be changed, supposedly will be changed in 2.06. For right now, if it engages, it engages. So these are probably vehicles up here and not likely soft infantry. He's laid off on this tank platoon, so the survivor is still slowly rebuilding her strength from morale and ammunition. He may regret not having pounded this one into scrap, but he might remember it. He may just finish her off this next turn, as well as these positions here. I'm quite surprised that this mechanized infantry platoon didn't get wiped out. Either he's forgotten about it along with the headquarters, but I'm willing to let my opponent make his mistake. Same with the headquarters company here. With my artillery has been rearmed and reloaded. I know I saw his tanks head off in this displace in this direction. They had arrived on the victory point location, and then the presence of my surviving Bradley forced them northward, so they displaced immediately. So I think he came in on a deliberate move, ended here, and then when he went into screen, my Bradley presence forced him northward. So he's probably sitting right there. Unless he's displaced further, I hope he hasn't, but I think he's right there. I'm gambling a whole hell of a lot right now. The mines have worked very well for the enemy. He's been hammering me by hitting my positions with deployed mines. Even though I'm not moving, they've been destroying lots of vehicles and infantry. So I'm going to try to do this, return the favor. Normally I wouldn't throw all three on top here, but they seem to be one of the few things that actually work in this game. Oh, pardon me, that are effective. And he's been hitting me with mines. He's got mines here. He's preventing me from movement. Normally I would try to prevent him from movement, but I think he's already made his movement, and they're all sitting on top here. There hasn't been much coming through. No one else has reported movement here, and I've got a couple that should see if there's any major units coming through. So I'm gambling quite a bit to hammer this one location with three volleys of mines. As well, I'm following it up with artillery. The artillery has been pretty pathetic in its killing ability. So I could go after the vehicles here or his SAM launcher, which retreated into this hex. And maybe there's one more around here somewhere, that a headquarters unit that destroyed my my machine gun unit before dying, but I don't know where he could have gotten off to. I don't want to waste the rounds on him. And there's probably one more armored personnel carrier somewhere out here, but that's what we'll have to take care of. There's only one unit, so I'm not going to waste all the artillery barrages upon her. So that's where I planned right now. My mortars are rearming, and let's see how this works out. The enemy continues to misdirect artillery fire onto empty hexes. Interesting. He's chasing, I don't know what he's chasing here, or what he could have detected. This is most likely he was aiming for my headquarters unit, which is long gone. But he's so low on fuel right now, he's probably going to stop within the next couple of turns, and then while he's rearming and refueling, I strongly suspect the enemy will detect him and take him out. Here goes my mine attack. Oh no, I guess the artillery went in first. No. Well, maybe I hope he hasn't displaced from this hex as well. That would be terrible to be wasting all this artillery. Oh, we do get an explosion. but no tool tip telling us what, no helpful tip telling us what might have been hit. First mine drops and we get secondary explosions. Excellent. So I'm killing something. I'm hoping it's tanks. Interesting how the enemy's hitting this hex. I don't even remember any headquarters or SAM unit going through here, but I could be wrong. I could be mistaken. If the enemy keeps hitting this hex while I move through here, he could just hit it again next turn. The Bradley is scheduled to move through here on her way through, on her way up into Overtshausen. Already there's a minefield here, and the enemy, even though I drop two or three, I'll be wasting them, but I'm happy with that if I can take out a few more mine vehicles. He may just clear this one right off. I don't think the game will allow more than one minefield on a hex. There goes his artillery strike just in front of the Bradleys that are coming in. I hope he uses it up before they arrive. That's the third strike there, so I got my fingers crossed that he has no more and my Bradley will be able to safely traverse the hex. I may already have used up, the mine may already be empty. I didn't see the tooltip show up telling me I used up all the mines, but it does seem as though no subsequent attacks have been detected. But with the mine hex here, I'm hoping that if I can slow him down, next turn I might be able to get some regular rocket artillery on him. Mines are designed to immobilize, prevent him from holding him at this kill zone so that I can bring other fire upon it. But since I wasn't able to deploy, he's already cleared it. Insta-clear. We continue to engage this reconnaissance unit atop the hill. Goodness knows why the enemy's blasting this area. Maybe he's just got too much ammunition. That's okay. I'm happy to let him blast. He's leaving, as long as he leaves the recovering tank platoon alone. Notice he's also hammering empty hexes here. Wow, that's where, maybe that's where the presence of the air defense unit was? Nope, that's right here still. So I don't understand what hexes he's trying to hit. Is he just doing reconnaissance by fire, hoping to get an explosion? That's awfully expensive. Now that the enemy has left my main units in the center unmolested pretty much, I've decided to try and resupply some of them to bring their morale and ammunition levels back up to maximum. This leaves me slightly exposed in the covered posture instead of the dug-in posture, but the enemy hasn't hit me. He's been blasting all kinds of forest, making matchsticks and toothpicks out of everything else. So I wonder if he's just doesn't see me and doesn't realize where I am and forgot all about me. So I'm taking that risk and I'm going to try to bring their supply readiness levels back up to 100%. In the south, I've noticed that the position of my headquarters covering this hole is not perfect. So I'm going to try to move it up into this hole. And we did the same thing as before. We noticed that the waypoint, we had the 3-hour delay. So I'm going to delete the waypoint in between and we'll go off zooming. See how quickly our air defense unit just took off like a racehorse once the blocking waypoint was removed. Same with my mechanized infantry headquarters here. The tank occupying this position has moved to cover northward, so I'm going to use the tow missiles from the Bradleys to cover this gap. I've got two headquarters platoons right here, or two headquarters sections, and I'm going to use the one with two Bradleys to cover up front, to give more firepower to the front. So we're rushing him in, and we still have the blocking waypoint, and we'll just delete that, so it'll take off. This other Bradley, or mechanized infantry headquarters, still has her blocking waypoint, and we'll keep it like that. In case I need to reinforce in the north, I can take it out and just race away. So it's immediate reinforcement while these others relocate. My mechanized infantry platoon is moving up to reinforce. He'll stop here, rearm, and then make the final push in. The Bradley has resupplied and brought its ammo back up, but the readiness is still very low. I don't dare to order another resupply mission yet, simply because if the enemy comes down, they'll force him to displace and run like a rabbit and get shot in the back. At least with this, even a low level of readiness, he has full ammo. Even yes, his morale is low, so he might be doing the bug out boogie, but if he can hold just even one or two salvos, he might get a couple of shots at any tanks that come back over here. I'm gambling again. My rocket launchers, now that I've used up all the mines, I still have access to the regular rockets, and I'm going to be dropping all three. There were a heck of a lot of explosions before, and I strongly suspect if he had units here, and if he didn't already order them to move, he's suffering the same 30-minute penalty I am. So his units won't be moving for another little bit. I might get one, maybe two, maybe even all three rocket salvos will catch whatever's remaining in this hex. I'm doing the same. I don't have many targets for the artillery. I guess we could go after the reconnaissance unit here, but reconnaissance units are worth nothing. We'll take a quick look. Reconnaissance unit are worth 11 victory points compared to a tank worth 50. So the return on investment is probably best here if we can get a hit whatsoever and aid the rocket artillery. The tanks arrived, and I'm leaving him to hold position, regain a little bit of readiness to cover the move as the armored personnel carrier makes their final approach. I'm going to set the surviving two mortar squads are going to open up and try to take out this reconnaissance squad up here. Here we go. My first rocket salvo arrives, and we're rewarded with secondary explosions. At least one tank. The mortars bombard the hilltop with no effect. The heavy artillery arrives. Oh, we get one explosion. There's a tank unit detected. Okay, looks like somebody escaped. Well, Mark, oh, and he's bringing it. I don't know if he saw it or he's just guessing. Looks like he's guessing in the north. It would be interesting to find out how he got these targeting areas. I haven't had anything here in a long time, but he seems to be just plastering all through. Oh, we did catch it. It looks like he escaped and the artillery followed him out. Wonderful. Another tank dies. Even the rocket salvo followed him out. We're rewarded by another tank death. Oh, it's that surviving M1 Abrams tank platoon that finally took him out. I think he's going to regret not having shelled the hex more instead of wasting it on empty hexes, on forest hexes and fields. Will he get the last Bradley? Nope. Random artillery would be interesting to know if the enemy actually saw anything here, or if he's just pounding suspected areas. He's plowing lots of holes in the ground, but every so often, even a blind squirrel gets lucky, and he takes out another one of my mortar squads. Look at all that power, and he can't find me to hit me. If he saw anything, he'd be pounding it. So I'm guessing he's just throwing it out there. But with now that he's seen one explosion here and seen fire coming out of these areas, next turn I suspect these hexes will be hit again. Another unit is detected. Looks like a headquarters unit making her two, possibly, making their advance. Caught in the crossfires, but we didn't get anything as they crossed the open road. Doesn't look like they've counter-detected. They did counter-detect the headquarters engineer unit, or engineer headquarters section. Here comes the Artie. And he finally kills a tank. If he had killed it earlier, would have saved his tank over Obertshausen. Oh, a long range shot from the Overwatch Abrams. The reconnaissance unit is finally wiped out. But that earns the Air Defense Vulcans artillery in response. Wow, that was quick. The thin-skinned vehicles, two of them explode. Just imagine if all that artillery had been concentrated on a single hex, there wouldn't be enough remains of the unit to even make proper identification. My opponent tells me that we've reached the sudden death level of 30% and that his forces are pretty much spent. And said that it's okay if we decide to resign now. I think this was a close near-run victory. Had he turned south instead of northwest, he might have captured two more, but that would have been an interesting fight. So, if he's conceding victory, I think I'll accept it. We have a short staff summary. I have 73% of all the victory position, so it's just a marginal success. We'll resign. And see that control passes back to NATO. This location. Because we have more subunits within range. Our overall rating is 82%, so just under a decisive victory, but a tactical success nonetheless. Our reported kills. And the final disposition. Looks like the enemy left the southern approach uncontested, and his main approach was through the center. Another motorized rifle company is making her approach through the gap in the barrier. It's a good thing that I did leave some units the headquarters and the cavalry unit to cover the south, or else we might be losing this one as well. But the tank, the cavalry, and two headquarters units, plus the remnants of this platoon and the air defense, should be able to hold them back. Look at all that artillery. Since we didn't take any, we'll take a look at the Soviet side. Look at all that artillery. 3, 9, 12 companies of artillery were registered on my positions. This concludes Test of Wills from Flashpoint Campaigns Red Storm.